I'm going to install and flash a flanged window unit in open stud construction. The first piece that goes on is a home wrap apron, approximately 12 inches wide, and it should extend at least one full stud length either side of the rough window opening and be held flush with the windowsill. After we install the apron, the next step is to install a 6-inch piece of Flexwrap on the sill. Eyeball the sides level, and I want to position this piece of Flexwrap so that it's flush with the interior of the rough sill. You should extend up the jambs at least 6 inches. After I install it, I'll seat it in the sill using a J-roller. And the next step is to flex the sill out over the face of the studs. We'll do the same on the other side. And then fold the vertical leg down onto the apron and use a J-roller to get good solid contact. After installing the sill flashing, put a heavy bead of DuPont residential sealant on the back of the window, jamb flanges, and head flange. But we're going to leave the sill flange uncaulked. With the sealant applied to the back of the flanges, install the window, plumb and level. After the window is set in place, we install fasteners per manufacturer's instructions. We'll install jamb flashing on both sides of the window using DuPont Tyvek flashing tape. We want the jamb flashing to extend above the window head flange an inch. And once it's positioned, I'll gradually work my way down, seating the flashing tape, pulling the release paper off as I work my way down towards the sill. It should extend at least to the bottom of the sill flashing. And I'll use a J-roller. Apply pressure to the flashing tape so that the adhesive contacts both stud faces. After the jamb flashing is installed, the last piece of flashing is the head flashing using 4-inch flashing tape. And this piece should be cut at least an inch longer than the width of the jamb flashing tape outside to outside. I'll use a J-roller to ensure full contact between the adhesive and the window header and the side studs. After the jamb flashing and head flashing is installed, we'll fold the apron that we installed first out of the way temporarily so we can install our first course of drain wrap. Now we'll roll out our first course of drain wrap. After we've installed the first course of drain wrap, we'll take our apron that we've temporarily taped out of the way. We'll remove the tape and fold it down over the first course. The next step is to install the second course of drain wrap. Now we'll roll out the second course of drain wrap. We want to be at least 6 inches below that course we just put in. And we'll roll the second course out completely over the window. After we've rolled out the second course, I'm going to cut out around the window opening. I like to use a pair of scissors rather than a utility knife so I don't damage the flashing that I installed previously on the jambs or the window head. After I installed the second course of drain wrap and fastened it, I'll come back and tape the opening, starting on the right jamb, and I'll tape where I cut out around the window head, and then I'll come down with the final piece around the window on the left jamb. Tape the horizontal seam where the second course overlapped the first course of drain wrap. And after the window is completely installed and flash, we'll come back and apply some DuPont window and door foam. It's a low expanding foam, and we'll apply it just in the cavity to seal the head and the jamb. This is how you would install and flash a flanged window unit in open stud construction.